Hello, my name is Barbara Willekens and I'm a clinical neurologist at the Antwerp University Hospital in Belgium. I'm a member of the Belgian Study Group for Multiple Sclerosis, which is an independent organization that unites all Belgian neurologists with scientific interest in multiple sclerosis. I'm here to present our poster on the safety and feasibility of a phase one clinical trial in multiple sclerosis patients. This is a collaborative initiative between researchers in Belgium at the University of Antwerp and between researchers in Badalona in Spain. What is the background of this research? We all know that the treatment landscape for MS has exponentially increased in the past decade, but higher efficacy treatments come with potentially severe side effects. Thus, there still remains a need for safer, but also very efficacious treatments. And in this respect, antigen-specific tolerization therapy is a very promising approach. We were able to show in vitro and in animal models that a tolerogenic dendritic cell vaccination might work for this purpose. The study design was presented, by the way, at the European Charcot Foundation conference in 2016. So you could still go back to that presentation and poster to check for the study design. The aim of this study is, of course, to check the safety and feasibility of this therapeutic approach. So how does it work in clinical practice? We screen MS patients according to predefined in-and exclusion criteria. Then they undergo a leukapheresis procedure, as you can see here on the pictures in the poster. PBMCs are isolated and cultured in the lab, and a mixture of myelin-derived peptide is added, and with a cocktail of cytokines and growth factors, a tolerogenic dendritic cell type is expressed. These tolerogenic dendritic cells that are autologous are then re-injected into the patient. In Belgium, we use an intradermal administration, and in Spain, we use an intranodal administration. But for the rest, the study design is identical in the two studies, so that we will be able to compare both studies together. The study design involves incremental doses in three cohorts, and here we present the interim results of the first dose cohort. We included three patients in Belgium and three in Spain. We originally screened 8 patients in Belgium. One of them could not enter the trial because the cell product did not comply with the pre-specified release criteria. In Spain, there were 2 patients that could not be included due to this reason. You can see in the table for the patient characteristics, that's a quite young patient population between 30 and 40 years of age. We have relapsing patients as well as progressive patients, but all patients had to show signs of disease activity before entering the trial. As for the results at this time point, we can see that for adverse events, it's mainly some local problems at the injection site with some redness or irritation and mild pain during the injection. As for safety results, we also measure MS relapses, and we also have frequent MRI follow-up. And we have seen that 2 patients experienced an MS relapse, one shortly after the first injection in Belgium, and the second one after between the third and the fourth injection. In the Spain cohort, there were no clinical relapses, but there was MRI activity during the study. And as far as we consider it altogether, this clinical and MRI activity was not really different from that before entering the trial. The patients are, of course, still in safety follow-up, and the further follow-up will have to determine whether this disease activity is just patient-related or whether it could be treatment-related. For the future, we will, of course, be continuing this trial after safety evaluation by an independent data safety monitoring board of the final results of the first dose cohort. And then we will start with the second cohort and later move on to the third cohort of patients, whereafter we can be able to finalize all the results together.